Hey guys, Cole here. So, if you've been trying to port some of the new Chapter 2, Season 2 models, you might have gone onto Umodel and have seen this. So, for a while, for a couple hours, there wasn't a fix. Recently, just now, a fix came out, so I'm making sure on that. So, yes, this is going to be happening to you if you use normal Umodel. You cannot use normal Umodel right now for this. Until a new update possibly comes out of it, we'll have to use a different program. To get the new program to export these, there'll be a link in the description where you can download it. It's called Fmodel. It's like a different version of Umodel and actually works decently well. It takes a lot more work to port right now until a Umodel update comes out, but for now, this is how we're going to have to do it. Alright, so once you've downloaded the link in the description, all you have to do is select all these and then go extract to. I'm just going to extract to my desktop because it's a good spot. So those will all go there. I'm gonna put these, all three of them, in a different folder. I'm just gonna call the folder Fmodel. Should probably call it something like that. I'm just gonna drag everything into here. I'm gonna put it in the middle so it's easier to see. So you just wanna open up the folder and then open up fmodel.exe. All right, so I'm gonna full screen this so we can see it better. So as you can see, we are in here. It's basically a really nice looking version of Umodel, except it exports things in the wrong format currently, so we have to use Umodel to actually convert it. So here's how we do this. So you're going to want to click on load, and then load all packs, and it's going to do some stuff down here. It's basically loading in all the packs, and then some text is going to appear here in a minute. Alright, so I'm just gonna open up Fortnite game. This is really similar to Umodel, actually. So you see, we can open up characters and player, and let me see what skin I should do. Alright, so I'm gonna be doing the henchman skin. So he's actually one of the large bodies, so you're gonna go into male, large bodies. And you can see the cat ones here, I forget what it's called, but the new cat skin is in there. All the skins are in here. So I just need a henchman one because it's right here. So we can open up this like we normally would. Now here's the one issue with this. This does not have a 3D viewer. So we can't actually view these 3D models. We actually have to just extract them. We have to extract them separately. So here's what we're gonna do. All right, so here's the annoying part. So we actually have to extract everything separately. I know it's kind of a pain. So you just wanna click on this and then export raw data. And it's going to say successfully exported right here. Basically, where this is all going to go is in... So basically, this is all going to go into a different folder. So if you go back to your Fmodel folder, you'll see there's an output folder here. And then you want to just look in there, go to exports, Fortnite game, content, characters, player, male, large, bodies, and then you can see I was doing the cat one earlier. And you have the henchman stuff, and then the texture that just now exported. So, yeah, that exports everything there. So I'm just going to go and export everything, and I'll show you what to do next. Alright, so once you've exported everything, here's what you want to do next. So you just want to open up Umodel like you normally would. By the way, I recommend pinning this to your desktop. I'm just going to make things easier. So next you want to open up Umodel. Now in here, you want to change the directory to your Fmodel folder. So I'll just go to my desktop, which is here. And then I go to my Fmodel. And you just want to find your exports folder. Now just press OK. Do override game detection, Unreal Engine 4. For you, there's going to be Unreal Engine 4.24. You can use that. I just use 4.23 because that's what I have in my current version. You want to press OK. And now you see we are in here. So it's this really small thing of all we've exported. So we can see we have our henchman guy here. So we can open up this. And you see we have this. So here's the henchman. We have the parts for him, so oops, that's not what to do. We have his glasses here. We actually need to export his head as well. I'll figure out where that is in a minute. Now texturing this will be a little bit different, actually. So I'm just gonna close everything. It's just gonna add what I'd normally do here. So I just add a camera. I don't normally add cameras, but I just like to now. So I can import the PSK like I normally would. Just to go to the meshes, and I just find my henchman meshes, import the body, just do the normal shade smooth. Now here's a little bit of a different part. Texturing it works really strangely in this, because textures might not be set up correctly. I think this one is set up correctly, but for the cat one I was testing out earlier, it was not. So let's just hope it is. So I'm going to import all the models here. And do the, what is this? This is his head. Oh, it's a different head. Okay, interesting. I'm not doing that one though. I'm doing this, the normal one. So I just do the glasses. These glasses are so small. It's beautiful. And then I go to heads and import that. So we have this here, as you can see. I'm gonna shade smooth everything. Oops, let me shade smooth the glasses, please. Great. Alright, so I'm gonna hide the bones for now while I do the texturing. So texturing should be like normal, but if you actually want to learn how to texture things, go to my U-Model to Blender tutorial where I show how to texture things, but I'm just going to speed this part up. Alright, so we're finally done porting this. Took kind of a while because a lot of the bones weren't connected properly, so I had to connect a lot of them manually. Anyway, we're done. So, last thing I just need to do is scale this down to 0.01. I like to go into my camera and then view selected so it's like at a perfect angle. It's just nice. So, yeah, then you just gotta do this external data, pack all into blend, and then you can just save it. So, yeah, if this tutorial helped you out, please leave a like and subscribe, and I'll make more tutorials soon. Don't forget to join my Discord too for free models and help and all that. So yeah, I'll see you guys later.